I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which stands one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Connie won't be with us tonight. Give her our thoughts and prayers for speedy recovery. She's doing pretty well. And she'll be returning at our next meeting.
Not tonight.
No, not next meeting.
She's going to be out there now. So she, we won't see her until the end.
We won't see her for a little bit, but she's doing great. All right. First on our agenda is our appointments and Lee Nichols, our public works director.
Public hearing first, John.
Oh, I'm sorry. Public hearing, I would say 31:95-B. Hearing required in order for the board to accept unaccepted unanticipated funds of the New Hampshire DOT in the amount of $116,009.33. And that is a government money that gave us for our local infrastructure money? Is that what that was for?
It's additional highway block grant money that's available and being distributed to all the towns. There was also bridge money that went to the towns that were already on the municipal managed bridge list. This is our share of that funding, and it is for infrastructure. And I think I put a letter, so both DOT and the Department of Transportation and the Department of Revenue Administration have put out letters because towns have started to ask what they can use it for. It's supposed to be used for similar things as the highway block grant money, but a little bit narrow definition of infrastructure. I did get an email ruling. We can use it for sidewalks, and we could also use it for the street scan van that will kind of do a scan of our roads and show us where our culverts and our water lines and sewer lines and
so we can do a map. Some machine that can
We want to do more research on that though, because there's other companies that do similar work, and I think we can talk more specifically to any of that. But nobody's made a decision. This money, this additional money, can be spent this year, but it is good until next year as well. And there may be additional funds that we can apply for next year, so we should start to have shovel-ready projects in the pipeline so that we're prepared to apply next year as well. What's going to happen is all the towns receive this, so the paving companies are being asked to do additional paving for, you know, so people are tied up, and we can't necessarily get a lot of work done this year. We had already been looking at doing the repairing the sidewalks in Union because of the discussion that took place during the Union Mill Dam discussion. So Lee and I had already talked about that. We're trying to get some pricing and talking to DOT about, you know, what they would accept, because we're not really jazzed about doing three-inch granite curbing and trying to plow on there. So Lee had already had that project kind of scoped out, been dealing with DOT about that. So we feel like that is a doable project for us. The street scan thing probably would not happen until next spring, but he's going to continue to research that. Like I said, there's other companies. The Technology Transfer Center has interns sometimes. UNH Cooperative Extension. There's different things and different companies that do that, but it's one of the things that Lee's looking at and getting more details.
Can we take that time and spend the money, or do we have to spend it immediately?
We have until December 31st of 2018. For that 116, and then there may be additional funds available next year that we can apply for. We won't just automatically get a check. We have $116,009.33 in our bank account right now. We got that check.
For the people at home, I'd like to give a little background to how we got here. So Governor Sununu and the legislature adopted Senate Bill 38, which has provided an additional $30 million to be distributed to the state's 234 municipalities for local highway aid. We passed that this year during session.
That's awesome. Where does that money come from? We were supposed to not have any
tolls.
Just on money?
Don't ask me that.
I won't. Let's move on. we close, any comment, anything?
Public hearing, Mr. Representative Cromwell.
Accept the money.
Okay.
It's your money, no. Taxpayer's money.
Keep it open? We have to accept the money during the public hearing.
I thought we closed it, and then you and I do that.
You can close the public comment and then make a motion to accept the unanticipated revenue.
You want to make a motion? I'll close the public comment and,
Mr. Chairman, I am enthused to make the, motion to accept, the taxpayer's money of $116,900.
$9.33. And I am enthused to be second. All in favor to accept?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? There is none. Thanks to the taxpayers.
Thanks to the governor for giving back our money.
Well, that's the other question, that's the other problem now. They're taking it to give it back, so why are they taking it in the first place?
Thanks, Ed. We're still giving it back. That doesn't always happen.
No.
Okay, so we'll move on to appointments. Our department, Public Works Director, Lee Nichols, is here to go over the winter sand, gravel, and wood. What you got, Lee?
We attempted, last year when Scott was in, to see how things were going to work if we didn't run that wood boiler. I do not believe that's an option. We ran out of wood in the spring. We went through about a barrel of oil a week, and it was still freezing in there.
Really?
I got a quote from Gail Crawford. If we get 20 or more floors, which usually we get about 22, it's $180 a floor.
That's cheap.
Set top to A1, I think it was, and one of the other firewood companies, they get $300 a floor.
Oh, yeah. That 180, that sounds cheap.
Yeah.
So at 180 times 20, does that keep us under where we don't have to fill that out for bid, or is that something we have to put up? Puts us under 5,000.
I mean, he's already got two prices. I'll see a point in.
Well, if it's not over 5,000, I thought.
Right, but it is a required bid.
Good.
Okay, that was my first thing. The second thing, I sent it out in an email. I don't know if you passed it on to them. The crushed gravel on winter sand.
If I can interrupt you just so I go back to the same thing. How do you feel about, are we going to be able to maintain it?
Yes.
You figured that out? Because I know that was always an issue.
It's, honestly, it's a pain.
Yeah.
What do we buy? It can be maintained.
Keeping it going.
The outside.
Somebody has to come in on Saturday and Sunday to keep it going, but usually I think we always had to transfer guys. They come over because they were coming in to work. They just come over first, get the wood stove, keep the wood fire going. Because that thing can't go out. If you're going to run it, you keep it running.
Is it through the hot water and heat over there, or is it?
Yeah. We have the oil burners.
Waste oil?
Yeah. And we also have the outdoor wood boiler. They're all hooked into the same system, so if the wood stove does go out, the wood boiler does go out, and the furnace kicks on from the boiler and the time it kicks on. We use the oil burner for backup.
But we've always had room on Saturdays and Sundays,
because yes.
They're not there,
yeah.
Or Fridays, or he's there, or whatever.
Yeah.
Whoever comes in on it at the transfer station runs over and throws wood in the wood thing, keeps
the
it
thing going. Burns for like 12 hours.
Yeah.
Once you look at
it. It doesn't just go up.
But okay. Usually last year, since Skip retired, last year we were going over for Saturday morning. Stokes it up Saturday morning, then before he leaves at 3:30, goes back over, fills it again, then runs all the way through to the next one.
Yeah, good with that.
So long as it's working for you guys.
Like I said, we tried this spring. With just
I can't believe that was that much. That building, are we lacking anything in that building? I mean, is it just uninsulated? That's a problem with using so much oil? Because I really thought we were going to do better with oil prices are so low.
We have the doors weatherproof. Scott brought someone in after the doors weatherproof. It's a company we used in the past. Wasn't happy with my still see daylight out of them. So I'm in the process of looking for a couple. Get quotes from a couple more over at door companies.
Just see if we can figure out where something is.
But I mean, in the wintertime, honestly, it's not so much not being insulated or weatherproof. Them trucks are huge.
Oh, yeah.
You have them out in the snow.
And they're cold when they come in. They take a lot of heat out of that building.
That and the plows are jam-packed with snow, so.
The, and plus we, you know, picking up, I mean, we should be able to get a lot of scrap wood that's off the side that we bring in to make up for the insurance. No, good, good deal.
Do we need a motion to accept the wood, or is that just going to be a budget?
It'll just be a budget item.
Also, I don't know if Kelly sent this out to you. This is the crushed gravel and winter sand bid proposal. Get posted so people can put in some bids. It's for all of them.
I think the part that's why they're not going to put it to the results.
No, I got it. I got to get the approval so we can post it.
How did the salt thing work? Did it work better using straight salt?
We used straight salt at the beginning of the storm. Then we did salt sand mix during the storm for traction, and then finished up with straight salt.
Yeah,
that seemed to
good.
Keep the roads a lot.
I thought so.
Yeah, if you guys are happy with that, then I'll pass it on to Tony. We can get it posted.
Yeah, just make a motion to put it out to bid.
Motion to put out to bid the
sand and gravel.
As presented by Mr. Nichols.
Second, all in favor?
Aye.
Next thing on my list is salt. I believe you have the Morton quote.
Yep.
However, today when I went back to the office after working on Old Stage, I had another quote.
Who's got the state bid list?
This company right here.
Granite State.
I just had it. Prices are the same for Morton and Granite State.
Thank you.
They were awarded New Hampshire DOT contract. It's 58.85, which is the same as Morton's.
It's Gulf River, right?
This is.
Yeah, that was safety.
Gulf River salt.
Is that the same as safety salt?
Yeah, same thing. Just different names. Same price. I like Granite State for two different reasons. Morton salt, when I called them, I got a call Pennsylvania last winter. If we got in a bind, it's taken 2, maybe 3 days to get it. These guys are right out of Portsmouth.
Oh, this is the Portsmouth sir?
And these guys, I had to wait till 8 or 9 o'clock in the morning to call them. Granite State says, sir, we can put an order in 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
The other one is going to be open as well. I'm going to do whatever you think.
Did this go up for RFP? Or bid?
Nope, this is just what they sent us because we dealt with both companies.
We won't get a price better than the state bid list, not with what they're.
No, I'm just making sure that we did the data we sent in a bid.
Morton sent us a quote just because we dealt with them last year. Granite State, I believe we were using the year before, and I'm afraid for that.
I'll make a motion to accept the Public Works Director's recommendation on a Granite State minerals to obtain salt and sand and gravel or whatever it is.
Just salt.
Salt.
Just salt. I'll second it with one more question.
Yep. Okay.
What is bulk lizard?
That is a salt that they add a liquid to, and it helps it work at a lower temperature, about for 75 something a ton.
I'm not going to use it now.
They just quoted it because last year they offered us a free truckload of it to try it.
Is that what Wilbur does when they're mixing that liquid outside?
Yes, and actually, Scott had started it. I got to get with a company that had sent him a quote and present it to you. There is one company, and I got to check a couple others, Innovative Solutions, I think it is, was offering storage tanks, the drop-in portable tank for the new truck or the one ton, with the pump and sprayer and everything. So it's magnesium chloride, which is a little more expensive than calcium. The advantage to it is, in the wintertime, we get the winter mix, you spray the salt pile of the trucks. I think that brings your melting capability of salt down from like 20, 15, 20, it drops it down to zero or 10 below.
It allows it to melt at a colder temperature.
Which I think would help us out.
Especially
with the freezing rain and stuff.
Yeah.
And they were going to give us all that stuff. We would just have to agree to buy so many gallons a year for 3 years, and the tank, the portable tanks were ours. And another 3 years, everything was titled over to them. The other advantage to that is, instead of calling in Allstate Materials to come calcium our roads, we race around trying to get them all graded so we can run out the calcium. If we have that, we get the summer mix of the magnesium chloride. As soon as we're done grading the road, we run right out. And we
I've talked about it before, and it's a nice product, and it's something, but it's, I think Wolfboro does it themselves, like you're saying, as for buying it all pre-done or whatever. And they get those big tanks out there, you just got a place to do it, a place to put them.
I was thinking, you know, once I get the information from all these companies and present it to you, if that is the route we decide to go, we would put the containment tank, the concrete containment tank between the salt and sand shed, right there, put the tanks right there so you could spray the pile. But I will be looking into that this fall.
I think it works good in our area because we have such different temperature drops. And we have a lot of freezing ground and we don't get scraped. It's hard, and then you take the fall because you think that you need to go out and scrape the road.
Is DES okay with using this in close proximity to water?
Nothing, well, except for Bottoman Road, we don't have anything close to water. We use sand around the lake roads.
So we don't use the salt at all on the lake?
The only place that I can think of that we use salt there, like Bottoman Road.
Can you just, before we even consider treating it, do anything, just check with DES and make sure
I'll get something from them, but magnesium chloride is considered more environmentally friendly than salt. And that's magnesium chloride, I think, is what DOT pre-treats the highways.
I've just been talking to some DPW directors that said in some ways the sand salt mix is more dangerous to the water because the silica in the sand binds to the salt and puts more in the water. So I just, whatever we can do to keep the water
good,
what the concerns are and for obvious reasons.
The other thing with the sand salt mix is those two things are fighting against each other. The salt is melting and it's making a brine which helps melt quicker and it spreads across the road. The sand is now trying to soak up all that water. So you're fighting. So that's why we found running sand before and after the storm is working.
Okay. Finish motion.
So to allow the Public Works Director to go with Granite.
Is it on?
Granite State. Menos. Second?
You were in second, you just have to go.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
And I have one more thing, kind of unscheduled. We're looking, because all the culverts were replacing on Old State and Wally Road before we made those new roads. I had Seth call because we're basically going to deplete our culvert stuff that we have over there. Right, Seth Call around the water industries, Eliminator, and HD Waterworks for all the different culverts we're going to need for that road, plus to have some on hand. HD Waterworks came in the cheapest all the way across the board on all the different sizes. We're looking at 4 12 inch, 13 15 inch, 118, 3 24 inch, and 136. Grand total of all of those, Water Industries came in at $6,465. The Eliminator came in at $4,972. And HD Waterworks came in at $3,801.
Is that all delivered? And
that's all delivered.
Right, right. Apples to apples, same.
Apple to, apples to apples, HDPE. I mean, I went. First one was Water Industries. And I just wanted to run that by you, even though it's under 5,000 to go with HD Waterworks.
I think that's great. I can't believe it's that much difference in that little bit of money. Okay.
And I believe that's all I have.
Good
job. Thanks, Dick.
Thank you.
Can you just make sure you do a purchase order?
Yes.
Good job. Okay, public comment. I'll skip over that. Looks like we got nobody in there. Unfinished business, the siding bids for the East Wakefield Fire Department. I have two of them. We opened them with the board.
Your recommendation?
Yeah. We have two bids. We have one from EF Dollaher and Sons at $13,810, and I have a second bid from, let me try to read that, it's Pello E Construction, and they were $15,600. So the low bidder of that would be EF Dollaher, which we would recommend to go, but we are slightly over our allowance for the job. So I would like to negotiate with the low bidder to see if we can get this done for what we have presented the town and been warranted to accomplish for 12 cents.
Seeing as FJ Dollaher would be the winning bidder, I would make the recommendation that we allow Chairman of the Select Board to negotiate a price to make sure that we stay in the warrant article price of $12,600.
I will second that. I think that's a great thing. I think it can be accomplished just so that we can keep it at the taxpayers' allowance.
We have to.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Tony, I give you these to do whatever you do in your thing, and I'll take care of calling them. I give you. Good job. Okay. If I cannot, then we'll put it back on the bid.
Perfect.
Okay. Town clerk. OHRV snowmobile registrations. I think that she wants to start doing this all in one kind of thing.
So she had brought this up, and I brought it to you at last meeting because the owner actually needs to sign the application form to offer this. She has had residents request when they're in here registering boats and other things to do their OHRVs and their snowmobiles. And so she had filled out the application and asked the board to sign it as the owner. Lino, I believe, was the one that was concerned that we not take business away from local providers. So he had asked what stores and businesses already do boat registration or already do OHRV and snowmobile registration. Seven Lakes Provision, Country Goods and Grocery, New Deal, Long Meadow Hardware, and Newt's. The thing is that they only get $2 of the registration, so neither Val nor I feel like we're taking business away. If the people are in Seven Lakes Provision and want to do their snowmobile, they're going to do it while they're buying groceries. But, you know, if they're here doing their boat or their car and they want to do it here, it's more a convenience thing. There's 31 town clerks throughout the state that do OHRVs and snowmobiles, so it's a pretty common practice. It's, you know, by no means all of them, but, you know, it's 10 or 15%. And again, she doesn't want to do it to take business away. It's a $2 that stays with the town, the rest goes to the state. But she does want it for the convenience factor for the people who do ask. We're not going to do advertising. We're not going to try to take business away from people. But she would like to do it as a convenience thing for the residents.
You, I think it was you that we made the comment that, did we ever ask, give a few calls around?
Yeah, we get the list of the buyers.
The list of the people who do it in town, the other people.
I would not be in favor of taking business away from the town.
I'm basically the only one that I know is the one in my area, which is the new deal, and they actually, I know that most businesses complain that it takes a lot of time to fill up that paperwork, but while they're filling it out, it gives someone more time to walk around the store and spend on goodies.
Yeah, they're getting gas, they're getting their cigarettes, they're getting their snowmobiles.
So did you call them? And did they say that, or you didn't?
No, I just got the list of who else does it. It's not our intention to advertise that in any way, shape, or form. She may put, you know, something on her window that says we do this too while you're here, but we're doing it strictly as a convenience, not for the money, and certainly not to take business away from anybody else.
That's why I'm wondering, is it even worth us trying to spend the time rather than the convenience for the public?
But the thing is, we're taking people out of their business.
Correct.
Here.
I agree.
And I don't think government should be more convenient than going into your own store.
Make a call to not accept.
I just think we don't accept it.
You don't want to stop doing boat registrations though, right?
No, whatever this is, OHRV and snowmobiles.
Okay, so your answer, you agree?
I'm with them. I mean, I think I'd do a little more research myself. I mean, I might even ask the question now that I'm remembering it. I should have asked it before, but I didn't ask, you know, some of the locals up there.
Well, you got three of them up there that do it, and they're on a major route.
Yeah, they're right on the trail system.
So if somebody comes over from Maine and says, hey, can I register my boat on a Friday afternoon at 6 o'clock and we're closed, and they stop doing them because we started doing them here, you know, the state's out that money, the town's out that money, and they're not going to use it again.
Yeah, we don't gain much other than convenience. They gain by someone walking around the store, but it takes 20 minutes to fill it out. No, I'm with you there. Okay.
So do you want a motion or do you want
to? No, I'll tell the governor. The answer's no. I'm sure she's kind of watching.
Okay, new. So they won't do that.
Yeah, it's quite a few months on the line.
So it's pretty convenient, actually. I mean, there's enough people that do it.
And they're open on hours.
Yeah.
So.
All right, ambulance policy.
So I promulgated this written policy on ambulance billing predominantly to deal with two recent requests I've had for hardship abatements of ambulance bills. Just to give you a little history, I know that when you started billing for the ambulance, Chief Nason was significantly concerned that people not feel that they didn't want to call the ambulance because they were going to get billed. The problem is that if you are going to bill Medicare and Medicaid, you have to bill everybody. You can't say, we know these people are poor, so we're just not going to bill them. You have to bill them, and then they can ask for an abatement of the bill. But if they have insurance, you know, you can submit it to their insurance, take that payment, and write off the balance bill. You have some prerogative, but in the first instance, you have to bill everybody for ambulance service. And so I think that, I don't know how long you have been billing for ambulance services, but you have had a few hardship abatement requests for ambulance bills, and there was no, to the best of my knowledge, after talking to Chief Nason, there was no formal policy of how you were going to consider and how you were going to write off bills. And so since I don't live here and these calls come through me to you, I have written a policy where I have prepared a policy, a hardship case review worksheet, which is very similar to the worksheets we use in welfare, you know, just to make sure that people don't have assets or money in the bank or, you know, other things that we are not considering, and that they are truly financially meet the requirements of hardship, and then I would make the decision and you would be the appeal board. When I originally wrote the policy, my idea was to, I would recommend to the board, but if I recommend to you and you make the decision, then there's no appeal board because you've made the decision. So again, I wrote it so that I would send the worksheet to the applicant, they will fill it out, I will get all the information, it's all confidential, it'll be returned to them at the end of the decision, I'll make the decision, notify the person, if they're agreed by the decision, you would be the appeal board.
And I'm probably going to say this is going to happen in non-public?
It can happen in public without the person's name, but I won't, and we won't discuss the hardship enough to identify anybody. And I will keep the backup information until the decision and the appeal are finalized. And then everything will either get destroyed if it's copies or sent back to the person if it's original.
I think it's a very clear application thing. I like the layout of it.
I just wanted a really formal policy so I know, you know, it's so that people, so I can, because I've had these two requests and it seems like different people can be treated differently, and not necessarily better or worse, just depending on who's doing it, it gets done differently. So I think if we have an application for somebody, the way it works right now is they call ComStar and then ComStar tells them to call the selectman's office. I think this, for me, I can send them the policy, I can send them the worksheet, they attach everything, I can go out and pick it up from them if they're elderly and don't drive or don't get out or can't mail it. I'll make copies for them. I'm not trying to make it more difficult to do.
I don't think it's difficult. I think it's pretty clear, big letters. I mean, it's very, I like
it. So this is considered a policy review, or are you actually looking for us to pass this?
I need you to pass this policy so that I have parameters in which to make these decisions. I have already taken the liberty of sending the worksheet to a resident with a letter who has requested it. She's elderly and has some family members that are gonna help her fill it out. I haven't gotten it back yet. And then there's another one that's 6 years old that is affecting somebody's credit, and they also would like a consideration, and I need to send them.
And this is the standard state financial form?
Similar.
Similar?
Yeah. There's some things we don't need. I think it's similar to what, it's actually the same form that the assessing board uses to do hardship financial abatements for taxes. So it's very similar. I think they call that a poverty worksheet though, and I didn't like the word poverty. So I changed it all to hardship and.
Motion to accept the ambulance billing policy and hardship worksheets and financial worksheets.
Second. All in favor?
Hold on.
Okay, sorry.
With an effective date, 60 days?
I've already sent it to somebody, so whatever you want to be. I'm going to use it because I'm not going to make a decision and avoid, so I need some information to make a decision. Whatever effective date you want it to be.
Well, make sure if anybody has any objections that they can voice their opinion before we put this into.
That's fine.
You want it for 30 days?
That works for me.
Mr. Chairman, with an effective date, effective October 1st, close enough?
Motion. Second motion. All in favor to accept? Aye.
Aye.
Nice job.
Two want to sign that, and I'll make sure Connie gets a copy of it so she's aware of it.
We don't have no money going out today. No capital reserve fund expenditures. No correspondence.
You skipped ahead.
Unscheduled matter, public.
Wait, you're on the letter supporting the review of intersection 28.
Yes, I have.
Oh,
I don't have nothing on my agenda.
You said you were going to bring it up.
Oh. Yeah. Can we talk about the letter that?
Sure. This one? Yeah, we can.
No, the letter that Selectman Evelani asked me to prepare supporting the town looking at the hazardous conditions at the intersection of Route 28 and 171.
Yep, we can talk about that.
We had a public hearing last Monday, a DOT hearing for 28 and 171. Representative Fulmer and myself were present. It was a very effective, very knowledgeable meeting. We learned quite a bit. The consensus is probably going to lean towards having a roundabout at the intersection of 28 and 171. And I was impressed with the reception of the Chairman Morgan, who was also present, that I feel that in the interest of this board is to send our regards and to and offer our encouragement to that board to go forward with their plans, and given the fact that we've lost a few people to that intersection over the last couple of years.
And I will say Mr. Morgan is a great selectman up there, and I believe that if we can encourage him to help him in any way, that would be good.
Can I make a motion that we unanimously send this letter, including Connie Trombley as signatory as well?
I will second that. All in favor?
Aye.
I had one other new business piece too that didn't make the agenda. So I had a gentleman who went into the town clerk's office and wrote a check. Or actually did not go to it. He wrote a check online, one of the electronic checks, and he left a digit out of his account number. So the check got returned, the e-check got returned as unable to locate the account. So it got treated by Profile Bank similar to an insufficient funds check. It was returned, we were charged $10. He was in this week, and he was really upset because he didn't mean to do this and he feels horrible. And so I am asking the board to waive the $25 town fee and only charge him the $10 fee that we got charged from Profile. It is not an insufficient funds, which I don't have as much sympathy for NSF checks that are returned. We spend a lot of time dealing with them, but he got the notice, he came right to us. He couldn't actually figure it out. He brought his checkbook with him. He said, I did everything online. I thought it went through. It was actually Val and I that realized he had left a number off at the beginning of his account number. It was an honest mistake. He was mortified. And he had, he's willing to pay the $10 fee. But I'm required to charge an additional $25, and I would like the board to consider waiving the additional $25 and just charge him the $10 that the town got charged.
Yeah, we didn't do anything to really deserve $25 if we didn't have. There's no insignificant funds on that.
So motion to waive the $25 fee for the check.
Mistake.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you. Now you can go. No capital reserve funds.
No capital reserve funds. Great. No scheduled correspondence. Unscheduled public comment number two. The
Nobody here?
With you, what are you going to say?
Oh, okay. I know you're here. I'm sorry. Okay, town administrator update?
So let's see. I have two things. So. We have the final of the 2016 audit. It's bound in my office. If anybody would like some
short reading.
I can send it to you electronically if you'd like to take a look at it. I encourage you to take a look at the management letter because that's where they cite us for anything that we should change. As you know, one of the things we get cited on was the rate of pay for detail hadn't gone through the board and wasn't in everybody's personnel file, so I've already taken care of that. I think there's one other thing, I can't remember what it is, but I will make sure that it's made public and that, you know, you guys get a chance to look at, take a look at it.
Great.
I finished the MS 434, which is the updated revenue. So when you do the 737 with the budget at the beginning of the year, you estimate revenue. Your final revenue numbers that are going to be used to set the tax rate are due September 1st. I did that form. There's no surprises there. Motor vehicle regs are up a little bit. Rooms and meals is about the same. So there's no big surprises. I will make sure that's a form that I sign and upload to the DRA portal, but I'll make sure that you guys get a copy of it when I finalize it, just because it will be in the packet that's used to set the tax rate. I would like to start looking at dates to set the budget meetings with the department heads for the Board of Selectmen, and Lino had suggested at the last meeting that we might want to consider doing an all day, get everybody done in one day. I knew Connie wasn't going to be at this meeting, so I asked her if there was a day the first week of October that would be a good date for her. She would prefer Wednesday, but I know you have school board meetings on Wednesday night, so she said the next best date for her would be Tuesday the 3rd of October. But do you guys want to look at your personal schedules and see if you can block out an entire day?
Tuesday.
The 3rd.
Or even on Thursday, the 5th, if she's okay with that.
She preferred Tuesday or Wednesday. I don't know why, but could you all do the 3rd if I can?
I'll make it work.
You can make it work? So let's shoot for October 3rd. I will schedule all the department heads in increments, and we'll get it all done. And hopefully a 8 to 5, we'll give a half hour lunch or something.
Yeah, I think it's
maybe.
Yeah, I think. We want to make sure that we're ahead of the school.
Well, and I will make sure that I will get you out what I have before I go on vacation. So that you have some time to peruse it and ask some advanced questions.
We just do ourselves anyway. It's pretty simple.
And then my other thing was, Brookfield set up a committee at their 2017 town meeting, a Brookfield Services Review Committee. And I had asked Chairman Zacher from Brookfield to share that report when it was made public to them, and I guess they got it a couple weeks ago and loaded it up to their website. It's a pretty detailed document. It looks into the services that Wakefield provides as well as their school district, and I believe they get Parks and Rec from Wolfboro. Mm-hmm. So it looks at all those things. I think the first 10 pages or so are the Wakefield, and there are some action items at the end of that study. I just wanted you guys to be aware, and I can make it available to our residents that are interested. Basically, the long and the short of it is that they feel that they are paying too much for police, ambulance. Although they think the service is fantastic, they have no complaints about the service, they think it should be based somewhat on equalized assessed value rather than just straight population. They feel like we're not billing for the actual services, we're billing on the gross and not giving them credit for revenues we receive. They think the administration is ridiculous because the contract administration is negligible.
Well, we can always go up to it.
Well, I just think we should take this under advisement and we'll discuss it at a later meeting.
Yeah.
So we can all read it and formulate questions.
Okay.
Before we pass any general comments.
I have taken it upon myself as part of the 2018 budget process. I'm looking into LED street lighting to save money. The city of Portsmouth put out an RFP, and Dover, Somersworth, and Rochester maybe liked it so much that they piggybacked on to Portsmouth's RFP and got it added on. There seem to be two major companies that do LED street lighting, Affinity and Siemens. So I'm just at the preliminary looking at RFPs, looking at what kind of savings. We spend about $33,000 a year on street lighting. So I don't know if it would be cost effective for us to look at replacing some of our street lights, but it's something I'd like to do because it's a fixed cost that we might be able to affect. There is some question about LED lighting having more blue light and being not as advantageous to animals. So some of the towns like Milford did a 4,000K light on highways and well-traveled roads, and like a 3,000K light on back roads and town roads. But I'm at the very preliminary looking at this just as part of the 2018 budget, and I just wanted to let you guys know that. And then I am going to be gone from Friday the 8th until Friday the 15th of September. And I would like your permission to work Monday, September 4th, Labor Day, and use Friday as my Labor Day holiday, because I'm actually flying out of Manchester at 3:30 that day. I think I'll probably get more done on Monday at Labor Day with nobody else in the building than I would a regular Monday. And that's all I have.
Okay. We got the Treasury monthly report. You look at that, we know.
Yep.
Everything looks good. You met with permit releases?
I just mentioned that I actually didn't look that good because there were some outstanding issues on the profile one. So.
I see.
Yeah, did you notice it? Looked at the variance. Well, if you look at this now, it looks nice. Glad you noticed. At the bottom, Charlie, you want to have a zero variance. You want everything
to balance out. Do we
have 30,000? No, that's the treasurer's balance. The variance is zero. That's the difference.
Oh, I see.
The old variance was $875,000, so that was kind of a mistake.
Yeah.
Well, that's a good fix.
So, it was just a typo, or was it?
We should have set out getting information that
we should be. What was it? The less.
The new ones.
Okay. Let me say. The school didn't take as much money. I didn't know if that impacted.
No, we transferred $1.8 million into the money market, and we've already realized $500 more in interest by moving some money into the money market, so we're getting some more.
Wonderful. Enjoy the cost cutting.
So we got two permit releases.
You do, sir.
We have one 10 Crestwood Ave. No, that's where they live.
That's where they live.
141 Red Gate Road. Got a motion to accept that.
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
Second, all in favor?
Aye.
We have another one on Old Pine Road. That was motion to accept that one.
So moved.
Second, all in favor?
Aye. hours, so Mike goes on.
I've got a manifest, treasurer's warrant for $542,149. I am looking for a motion to accept.
Where's it going? Is it our?
$475,000 is going to the school.
Motion to accept, Mr. Chairman.
Second, all in favor?
Aye.
You got anything you want to talk about?
It was just that letter.
Okay. I got the board minutes for August 9th. I don't know what to do on this one. I have an envelope that's sealed.
You can open it.
I can.
It's the minutes you voted to seal.
Okay.
But they have to remain sealed for me to give them to people. I have a let's seal over here for you to sign. Again, it's for you to open. I'm assuming you're going to give them back to me after the bus driver. When they go into the safe, they will be sealed again.
All right, so do we do these separate? Like, do we do the August 9th meeting first, and then do we do that? How's that?
Well, you've already voted to seal. So all you have to do
is accept these ones?
Is accept them.
So do I have a motion on the table to accept the board minutes for our meeting on August 9th, 2017?
I will make that motion for to seal the minutes for section number 3.
You've already made the motion.
You've already sealed them.
Yeah.
You're just making a motion to approve them.
Motion, okay. Yeah. I'm making sure it's 3 because this one we didn't seal.
Right.
I'm sorry. I have
to make more than I did.
Apologies. So whatever you just said.
Motion to accept the sealed minutes for section 3 and I'm not involved.
Okay, second. All in favor?
Aye.
So do we now just accept our minutes?
Yes.
Okay. Do I have a motion to just accept our board minutes on the 9th of 2017?
Yeah, on the 9th, yes.
Yeah.
Motion move, Mr. Chairman.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.